and the infections. We will discuss general brain cells. First, for hand infection. In general, hand infection much more common in manual workers and housewives. Why? Because the most important predisposing factor for hand infection is trauma to the hand, as wound or puncture, which occur usually in the kitchen or in manual workers. The route of infection is direct introduction of infection through the wound, puncture, or trauma. Less commonly, infection may due to spread from surrounding structure, like infection in one space in the hand may spread to the neighboring species. The organism in at least 90% of cases is Staphylococcus aureus. Pathologically, the condition starts as cellulitis, which followed by either resolution or suppuration. Sloughing and necrosis and pus formation occur rapidly by bacterial toxins or by pressure necrosis. Why? Because species in the hand are very small, very narrow, and closed species. Therefore, if inflammation occur, congestion and edema leading to high pressure in this small closed space, leading to pressure necrosis. Hand infections are classified into cutaneous and subcutaneous infections, facial species infection, and infection of synovial flexor sheaths. And each one will be discussed in detail in the next videos. What is the complications? Complication of hand infection. Hand infection is abscess. Therefore, complication like acute abscess in the previous videos. Clinical picture as any acute abscess before suppuration and after suppuration as any abscess. As any abscess, there is pain, tender, and swelling in the site of inflammation. And the pain increase by dependency and relieved by elevation. Pain also increased during sleep. Why? Dependency leading to interference with venous and lymphatic drainage, leading to high pressure in the inflamed area, leading to more pain. And during sleep, there is congestion all over the body, and congestion in the inflamed area here during sleep will increase the pain. You should ask the patient about the maximum point of pain and tenderness, because the site of maximum pain and tenderness is diagnostic for the site of the space affected. Example here, maximum point of pain and tenderness, this is a bulb space infection. Infection here, this is a web space infection, etc. Usually there is severe diffuse edema, maximum over the dorsum of the hand. Why? Because the subcutaneous tissue in the dorsum of the hand, there is loose areolar connective tissue, which allow accumulation of excessive edema, in contrast to the dense adherent tissue in the palm of the hand. What is the investigations for hand infection? As any acute abscess, investigations for diabetes mellitus, culture and sensitivity, Billion X-ray may be needed to detect the affection of the bone, etc. Treatment of hand infection as any abscess. Two stages, before suppuration and after suppuration. Before suppuration, antibiotics against Staphylococcus aureus as fluoxacillin, amoxicillin, erythromycin, or cephalosporins. In addition to antibiotic, analgesics to relieve pain. Locally to relieve pain, elevation is very important. Elevation of the hand by any means, by arm to neck sling, or elevation during sleep like that. During normal activity, elevation of the hand to decrease congestion and edema. Therefore, elevation by any means is very, very important to relieve pain and edema. The position of the hand. The best position in this stage before suppuration is the position of rest. What is the position of rest? This is the position of rest. If you leave the hand to take the rest position, the little finger is maximally flexed and the index finger is least flexed and the thumb is in opposition. Therefore, this is the position of rest. Maximum flexion in the little finger, least flexion in the index, and the thumb in opposition. Hot application to bring more blood for the inflamed area, and more blood means more antibiotic, more antibody, and more leukocytes. Frequent examination of the hand and follow up for this examination to detect the early manifestation of pus formation. If pus is formed after suppuration and pus formation, incision and drainage as any pus in the body and as any suppuration all over the body. First of all, anesthesia. In minor infection like this. This infection around and beside the nail is called baronychia. Or infection here. This is called bulb space infection or phelon. In case of phelon or bulb space infection, these are minor infections. Usually we perform ring local anesthesia. In the root of the finger, inject the local anesthesia. Usually in any site in the body, we add to the local anesthesia adrenaline to prolong the effect of the local anesthesia in any part of the body except in the fingers or toes, because if there is adrenaline with the local anesthesia, this leads to vasoconstriction of the blood vessels and the acute ischemia, which may be vasogangrene. Therefore, ring anesthesia without adrenaline, or there is alternative, which is median or ulnar nerve block. Injection of the local anesthesia around the ulnar or median nerve to make anesthesia in the related fingers, which are supplied by ulnar or median nerve. Other hand infections need general anesthesia. Therefore, local anesthesia only for the phelon or bulb space infection or in Baronikia. After anesthesia in the hand, never wait for fluctuation. Therefore, when the bus is formed, incision and drainage. How to know formation of bus? By throbbing pain and hectic fever. Also, other evidence for bus formation is if there is no response to intensive antibiotic therapy for 24 hours, one day, no response to this antibiotic, this indicate bus formation. During incision in the hand is highly vascular, and to avoid blood loss, the field should be bloodless. How? Elevate the limb for few minutes to allow venous and lymphatic drainage. Then apply a sphygmomanometer cuff inflated above the systole to prevent blood flow to the hand. Therefore, the operation can be done without any loss of blood. The incision and drainage should be done in a selected area, usually over the maximum point of pain and tenderness. And the incision should be away from the important structures, away from vessels, nerves, or tendons. And during hand incisions, never cross a skin crease, because we know that if you cross a skin crease, fibrosis later on, leading to limitation of movement and stiffness of joints. After incision, a sinus forceps is introduced to divide all loculi and drain all pus. Take care during evacuation of pus from this abscess. What is this abscess? This is a skin, and this is a subcutaneous tissue containing pus. But part of the abscess penetrates the deep fascia and connected with a larger abscess deep to the deep fascia. This abscess is called collar and stud abscess. You may incise in this patient the skin only and evacuate this pus, leaving most of the pus deeply without any drainage. Therefore, search for collar and stud abscess. After complete evacuation of a pus, a soft rubber drain is inserted and dressing. After incision and drainage, put the hand in the best position of function. What is the best position of function? The best position of functions are the fingers are approximated to the thumb, like holding something. Post operatively, physiotherapy to avoid stiffness of joints of the hand. This is the general principles for hand infections. Thank you for good listening and good luck.